हेलो एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द पीडीसी सेकंड टाइम, जस्ट आई वांट टू कवर द सिलेबस व्हिच इज एडेड दिस ईयर। ओके, सो इन टू और थ्री लेक्चर्स आई विल कवर द सिलेबस of the PDC which is added in GATE 2021. The topics which are added this year are फर्स्ट वन टॉपिक दैट इज द मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्रोसेस वेरिएबल्स। फर्स्ट वन टॉपिक इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्रोसेस वेरिएबल्स। यू कैन से दैट इट इज नॉट द basically that topic which is added this year, means in the last years we also discuss or we also read this topic, that is the measurement of process variables. So basically in this topic I told you the equipment's name which we use basically in the chemical industry to measure the our mainly five process variables, that is the liquid level, that is the liquid level, that is the concentration, or you can say the composition, concentration, or you can say that is the composition. After that, pressure, flow rate, and temperature. In this particular topic, the important point is to remember the name of the equipments or measuring devices or sensor which are used to measure the liquid level, concentration or either composition, pressure, flow rate and temperature. Other than that, the questions which already came in the GATE exam from this particular topic were the range of the measurement of process variables the devices can measure and the working principle on which they are working. So these are the points from this particular topic on which the question arises in the GATE exam. Okay, so this portion I will discuss later, but you know I already give you the sheet, okay, all about the measurement of process variables. Okay, so that is the basically instrumentation portion, so I will discuss this particular topic later. Second one topic, that is sensors and transducers. Sensors and transducers. So, and third one topic, that is the डायनामिक्स ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स, डायनामिक्स ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स। सो दैट व्हेन वी स्टार्ट मीन्स आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द प्रोसेस डायनेमिक्स एंड व्हेन वी स्टार्ट ऑल अबाउट द प्रोसेस कंट्रोल, एट दैट टाइम आई टोल्ड यू व्हेन वी मेक द क्लोज लूप, सो इन द क्लोज लूप आई टोल्ड यू द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स विच बेसिकली यूज्ड, सो दैट वॉज द प्रोसेस बेसिकली विच वी वॉन्ट टू कंट्रोल, either that is the physical process or the chemical process. Other than that, measuring devices, you can say the sensors, and after that the controllers, final control element, transmitters, other than that transmission lines also. So when we start the process control and I told you that how you can control the process in the closed loop by using some components in the closed loop, so at that time I told you all about the sensors and transducers. So what are the transducers and how you will select the measuring devices, because for the measuring devices we will select in such a manner that they measure the process variable accurately and easily, and after that transmit the signal. If they can not transmit the signal, so in this case we can say there is we are not using the measuring value of the measuring devices or the sensors. In this case we can use the transducers. Transducers are the devices which are basically used to convert one form of energy into the another form, or you can say one type of signal into the another type of signal. So after that the signal from the measuring devices, so means in the sensor, means we can add up in the series with sensors, we can add up in the series transducers. So after that from the measuring instrument or from the measuring devices, the measuring signal can be easily transmit by converting the signal into the another form. Either they are the pneumatic signals which can be easily transmit, or either they are the electronic signal means in the form of the electric current or electric voltage. Are you finding my point? So topic second and third I will discuss later. The today which I want to discuss, the today topic which I want to discuss, that is the P and ID equipment symbols. P and ID equipment symbols. Okay. Basically, you will find out in your notes, because currently we are completing the PDC a second time, or you can say it as this is the revision class. So when we complete the PDC first time, so at that time I told you just some introduction regarding to the P and ID equipment symbols. But in this today class, because this topic is added in our syllabus, so I will discuss in very detail. Okay, so today I want to discuss that is the P and ID equipment symbols. What does it mean? What does all about the P and ID. So that is nothing but that is the piping. P stand for the piping and instrumentation. Instrumentation. Diagram, symbols, piping and instrumentation, diagram, symbols. Are you getting this point? So basically these symbols, P and ID equipment symbols, are used to document the control system for their process. Means with the help of the P and ID symbol, we can easily know that the line system, or when we are transferring the signal, so these signals are in the form of or these signals are electric signals, and these signals are hydraulic signals, pneumatic signals. So you can, by see the process diagram, you can easily find. So for this condition we use the standard symbols, and they are applicable in anywhere or in any industry, either that is the petrochemical industry, that is the petroleum industry, air conditioning industry, fertilizer industry. Means any industry we use these standard symbols for the instrumentation, for the control purpose in the chemical industry. Okay, so first of all, write down all about the P and ID equipment symbols. So write down P and ID symbols are used by the chemical process industry to document the control systems, to document the control systems for their processes. So these P and ID symbols basically produced by the Instrument Society of the America, that is the ISA. Okay, so just I will tell you some symbols which are generally used or basically used in our chemical industry. Okay, so write down the Instrument Society of America. So are you finding that is very easy? P and ID symbols are used for the chemical process industry to document the control systems, because by seeing the process diagram we can easily identify that the line symbols, means by easily analyzing the line symbols, by easily analyzing the symbols for the final control element, by easily analyzing the measurement symbols, that which measuring instrument or sensor is used in our industry, and when the signal is transferring from the one form to the another form for easily transmission. Okay, so for that there is the need of the some standardized symbol. So they are basically produced by or given by the Instrument Society of America. That is the ISA. Are you finding it or not? So write down the Instrument Society of America. ISA produce a standard document that is the instrument symbols and identification. Instrument symbols and identifications that establish a uniform means of designating instruments instruments comma control systems and sensors used in establish a uniform means of designating instruments, control systems and sensors used for measurement and control in a process. That is the same thing as by seeing the traffic lights, you can easily know that when there is the green light, okay, what does it mean? When the light turns red or the yellow, what does it mean? The same case here, by seeing the symbol in the process industry, okay, on the process flow diagram, you can easily recognize. So due to this, for a uniform means, because the symbol that will remain same either in the fertilizer industry, means suppose we are using the valve, so if I'm taking the generic valve, so that is the symbol of the valve, you know very well. So if in the process diagram you are finding such type of valve, you can easily say that is the valve of the, or that is the symbol of the control valve. Okay, that is the generic symbol. So in this way you can easily recognize. Are you finding this point or not? Write down these standard symbols are used in chemicals, petrochemicals, petroleum, fertilizers, metal refining, air conditioning, power generation industry, other numerous process industries. Are you finding it? So after that, write down some common conventions that are used for identifying some common conventions that are used for identifying process instruments and control on process drawings. By seeing the process drawing, you can easily recognize from this equipment to this particular instrument the symbol which are transmit are in this form, or the valve is, that is your glow valve, either that is your gate valve, pneumatic valve, needle valve, butterfly valve. So this you can easily recognize by seeing the process drawing. Okay, so due to this we are using some common conventions which we are calling it as P and ID symbols, means piping and instrumentation diagram symbols. Are you finding it or not? So first I want to tell you instrument line symbols. Instrument line symbols. I already told you. If you see the notes, instrument line symbols. So in this case we want to know, or we will find some line symbols. Line symbols, you can say, from instrument to instrument to process and equipments or from instrument to instrument, one instrument to another instrument. Instrument to instrument. You can say instrument to instrument connections. So you can easily know when you are going from Delhi to Mumbai by road. So you can find easily that from this place to that particular place, okay, that is the national highway this, and after that you will reach on this particular national highway, and after that that will link with the Mumbai. So you can easily know that when it will be the national highway, where it will be the state highway. So the same case here, when we are transferring the signal or from the instrument to the process or to the equipments, so we use the line symbols, or either we are transmitting the signal from the instrument to the instrument, so we use some symbols. So in this particular section I will discuss all about the line symbols. So first I want to tell you in this case, if we are using this line symbol, what does it mean? I already told you when we discuss all about the process control. What does this symbol mean? So that will be your pneumatic signal. Means you know that these signals will be in the form of compressed fluid signal. Compressed fluid signals. Pneumatic signal. So means compressed fluid means compressed air signal. You know very well, when we have the pneumatic control valve, so in this case the output from the controller, that will be in terms of the pneumatic signal, means that will be the pneumatic signal means the compressed fluid signal, you can say that will be in the form of the pressure, okay, and the range lies in between 3 to 15 psig pound per square inch gauge pressure. So the range lies in between 3 to 15 psig I already told you, okay. So second one, that is all about the dotted line. Or either you will find out as this signal will be your electrical signal. You know, electrical signal. Third one, this signal will be your software signal, means the signal which basically connect the DCS system with another DCS system, or DCS system with another PLC system or the PC system. So we use the software signals. So that is the another type of line symbol. So that will be our software signals. Are you finding? Next one, the fourth one, that will be your the solid line, solid state line. That will be instrument connection, instrument connection to process and equipments. Instrument connection to process and equipment. After that you will find out as if the signal is in this form. So that will be your hydraulic signal. Hydraulic signal. If signals are in this form, so these will be your optic fiber cable. If the signals are that is solid line and that is a means connect by a single dash, so in this case that will be your undefined signal. Undefined signal, and these signals are used for process flow diagrams. Next one, eighth one, if you are finding this, that is a solid line. So you will see that solid line is basically used for instrument connection to the process and equipments. But in this case, what you will find out, you will find out that just starting of this line, it will be written as that is the PA. PA stand that will be your plant air. And other than that, you will find out, or it will also indicate the supply pressure that are required. Means the pressure that is required in this particular line. So either that is in kilopascal or either that is in PSIG. So it will be clearly mentioned. So you will find out as that is the plant air, or either it will be written as NS. That will be NS stand for that is the nitrogen supply. Nitrogen supply. You will find out either it is written as GS. That is GS stand for that is any other gas supply. So if you are finding this type of line symbol, and in the starting of the line it is written as PA, so that will be the plant air, nitrogen supply, or that will be your any gas supply. So in the process diagrams you will find out as this type of solid line, and it will be written as either PA, NS, GS. So in this way, so you will easily recognize. So what you will find out as, you can write out as that will indicate supply pressure as required. For example, if it is written as PA 70 kilopascal, so you will easily recognize that in this particular line the plant air pressure required is that is the 70 kilopascal, or either NS nitrogen supply, you will find out as 150 PSIG पाउंड पर स्क्वायर इंच गेज प्रेशर। द सेम वे यू विल फाइंड आउट एज द सिग्नल इन दिस फॉर्म, सो दैट विल बी योर ES, मीन्स बिफोर दिस सॉलिड लाइन यू विल फाइंड आउट एज इट इज रिटन एज ES, सो दैट विल बी योर इंस्ट्रूमेंट इलेक्ट्रिक पावर सप्लाई। ES स्टैंड फॉर दैट इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट इलेक्ट्रिक पावर सप्लाई। आइदर यू विल फाइंड आउट एज इट इज रिटन एज HS, so it will be your instrument hydraulic power supply, hydraulic power supply. The same way as if it is written as HS, so what will it indicate? So that indicate pressure as required. That will be, suppose for example HS 70 PSIG, it means that will be the hydraulic power supply and its required will be 70 pounds per square inch gauge pressure. So these are basically some line symbols which connect the instrument to process or either instrument to instrument. Are you finding? So if the question arises, so that is the simple straight solid line. What does it mean? Means that will be your software signal, either that is your electrical signal, either that is your pneumatic signal. So, and in one option you will find out as that is the instrument connection to the process and equipments. So in this case you should easily recognize by some 7 to 8 line symbols, that is in a solid line. So you will find out as 2 dash line, means these 2 dash line, these 2. So if the signal are in this form, okay, on the process diagram, so these will be your pneumatic signals. Pneumatic signals, you know, will be in the form of compressed fluid signal, that is the compressed air signal. So in the pneumatic valve, I already told you that the air that will apply the pressure on the actuator, and after that, according to that, that valve will be open or close, means that is the air to close or air to open valve. After that, the second one, electric signal. So electric signal will be denoted either by the dotted line or in the solid line. So there will be the 3 dash line. So that will be your electric signal. And after that, single solid means that is the straight line with single dash line, so that will be your undefined signal. Basically this type of signals are used for the PFD, process flow diagrams. If solid line you are finding it as that is basically cut by the letter L, so that will be your hydraulic signal. If the signals and you are finding that is the some wave, so that will be your optic fiber cable or optic fiber signals. If you are finding that is the straight solid line, so that will be your instrument connection to the process and equipments, software signal. And after that, on the before the solid line, if it is written as PA, so that means the plant air. And at this point you will also find out that PA simple 70 kilopascal, so you will easily understand that, or what will that indicate? That will indicate the supply pressure as required, or supplied pressure for the nitrogen, or for the nitrogen supply required. So obviously that is the 150 PSIG, so same for the other any gas supply. Same if it is written as ES, so that will be an instrument electric power supply, instrument to instrument. Okay, HS, that is the instrument hydraulic power supply. So these will be your line symbols, some line symbols. Are you finding it or not? So these are something like it as the traffic rules. I already told you. Are you finding it or not? Tell me fast. Any other doubt or any doubt? Hydraulic signals कौन से होते हैं? समीक्षा, देर विल बी द ऑटोमेटिकली चेंज इन द फ्लूड प्रेशर. ओके, suppose the fluid, if you can, you are taking that as the water, so there will be the automatically change in the pressure signal of the water. So this type of signals are called as the hydraulic signals. Next one, some signals regarding to the final control element. So you can write out as final control element symbols. Final control element symbols. So simple, I told you that is, if that is your control valve, so that is the symbol for the you can see it as the valve, or you can see it as that is the generic valve, a simple valve. Second one, if you are finding in the generic valve symbol there is the vertical line, this type of line, so this will be the symbol of the gate valve. Gate valve, and just in front of that you can write out as, sometimes it is also denoted it as, is that is the vertical line, because in the symbols of the final control element, don't confuse, because this valve, if that is simple valve, so you will find out as that will be in this way. Aapka kuch is tarike se bhi ho sakta hai valve. Okay, if there is the vertical line, so that is called as the gate valve. Okay, so you will find out as that is the vertical line, in between that is the two vertical lines, so or simple, that is the symbol of the simple valve, or you can say it as that is a generic. Okay, और दिस विल बी, और दिस फर्स्ट वन दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज टू, दैट इज ऑल्सो द सिंबल ऑफ टू वे वॉल्व. टू वे वॉल्व मीन्स यू कैन इजिली ट्रांसमिट और द ट्रांसपोर्ट द फ्लूड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट और आइदर फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट. सो दैट इज द जेनरिक टू वे वॉल्व. इफ द सिंबल आस्क इन द गेट एग्जाम फॉर द जेनरिक टू वे वॉल्व और आइदर दैट इज सिंपल जेनरिक वॉल्व, सो दैट विल बी द सिंबल फॉर द गेट वॉल्व. सो दिस सिंबल कैन बी आस्क और आइदर दैट विल बी द इन जेनरिक वॉल्व. जस्ट ड्रॉ ए वर्टिकल लाइन, सो दैट विल बी योर गेट वॉल्व. रिगार्डिंग टू द न्यूमेटिक वॉल्व, यू नो वेरी वेल दैट इज ऑन द जेनरिक वॉल्व यू विल यूज दैट इज द एक्चुएटर. सो इट विल बी योर एक्चुएटर और यू कैन से जेनरिक टू वे वॉल्व. ऑन द जेनरिक टू वे वॉल्व जस्ट इफ यू आर यूजिंग दैट इज द एक्चुएटर, ड्रॉइंग द एक्चुएटर, सो दैट विल बी द सिंबल ऑफ द न्यूमेटिक वॉल्व. सिंबल ऑफ द न्यूमेटिक वॉल्व. आर यू फाइंडिंग इट? यू नो वेरी वेल दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्चुएटर. सो दिस विल बी द सिंबल ऑफ द न्यूमेटिक वॉल्व. Fourth one, in case of the globe valve, what you will find out, that will be the symbol. That will be the symbol of the globe valve. In case of the plug valve, what you are finding, that will be, means you can say that will be your open circle. So that will be your plug valve. It's another symbol which you will find that is that will be the symbol of the plug valve. Glow valve, so in the glow valve, so that will be the circle, means just you will find out as that is closed, that is the open circle, so that will be your plug valve. Next one, that is your ball valve. Ball valve, so the ball valve, that will be in two-way valve, generic two-way valve, there will be the ball, means in this way, so that is called as the ball valve. As I already told you, you can understand that is the simple generic valve, symbol of the generic valve. So in this case, just that is the ball in between the generic two-way valve, or that is the generic valve or the simple valve. If we are using the ball, so that will be also the symbol of the ball valve. Are you finding it or not? Sometimes you will also find that will be in this way, so that is the generic valve symbol. And if we are using the ball in this manner, so that will be also the ball valve. यू कैन फाइंड आउट इन दिस मैनर ऑल्सो. दैट विल बी ऑल्सो द सिंबल ऑफ द बॉल वॉल्व. सो नाउ दैट शुड बी वेरी क्लियर टू यू द डिस्टिंग्विश और द डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन द प्लग वॉल्व एंड दैट इज द बॉल वॉल्व एंड इन प्लग वॉल्व एंड दैट इज द ग्लोब वॉल्व. सो दीज आर सम स्टैंडर्ड सिंबल. आर यू फाइंडिंग इट और नॉट? So I already told you generic two-way valve, that is generic two-way valve. So after that you can find out as three-way valve. Its symbol is फोर वे वॉल्व. सो दैट विल बी द सिंबल ऑफ द फोर वे वॉल्व. दैट इज वेरी इजी एज द नेम सजेस्ट. थ्री वे एंड द जेनरिक टू वे, फोर वे. Next one, that is safety angle valve. Or that is also called as generic two-way angle valve. So that will be the symbol. Safety angle valve or generic two-way angle valve. That was the generic two-way valve. That is the generic two-way angle valve, or that is also called as safety angle valve. So if the question arises for the safety angle valve, so just that should be very clear to you. Next one, that is your check valve. So that will be the symbol of the check valve. In case of the needle valve, so that will be your symbol of the needle valve. Next one, that is all about the diaphragm valve. Diaphragm valve. So for the diaphragm valve, that will be the symbol, or either it will be in this way. either you can find out as in this way. So these are the symbol of the diaphragm valve. Third one, that will be your pinch valve. So that will be the symbol for the pinch valve. Next one is butterfly valve. So you will find out this type of signal for the butterfly valve, or either that will be in this way. Or I already told you that generic valve, that will be a symbol of the generic valve. If you are finding it as this symbol in between, means that is the tilted line with that is closed circle, so that will be the symbol of the butterfly valve. If you are finding such type of signal, means that will be your generic two-way valve, or that is simple valve. If such type of signal, so that will be your manually operated valve. Manually operated valve. That will be your manually operated. So these will be the simple symbols of the final control elements, because when we discuss all about the final control element, so I told you that the final control element doesn't only mean all about the valves. So the final control element may be your variable speed pumps, compressors, okay, variable speed pumps, variable speed compressors. But generally in our syllabus we deal the pneumatic valves, pneumatic control valves. Okay, so that is the one type of final control element, or one of the final control element. So if you are finding that is simple this symbol, this P&ID symbol, piping and instrumentation diagram symbol, P&ID symbol, so just you should easily know, means on the process diagram if you are finding it as such type of symbol. Okay, gate valve, pneumatic valve, glow valve, plug valve. Okay, in case of the plug valve, I told you that when we deal all about the air to open or air to close, in air to open and air to close, so I told you that in this case there may be the different type of valve, that is the double seated, and if the shape of the plug also changes, so on that behalf we can the valve may be your hyperbolic valve or quick opening valve, linear opening valve. So on that behalf, or so in this case, what I already told you, that it is your plug, means that will be your seat and this will be your plug. There will the it is your stem, that is the spring, and in between the spring and the stem there will the valve packing, and after that what you'll find out, you'll find out as there will be the actuator. So as you will apply the air pressure, so after that there will be the movement in the stem in the downward direction, and after that you can see when the air pressure is applied from the top, so that will be your air to open, and when the signal will be filled, so that will be your fail closed valve. That will be your fail closed valve. In this case I already told you that all about the process modeling equation and the transfer function, the relation in between the stem position and the pressure. Okay, that if input is your pressure, so after that how the stem position will be changed and how we can make its dynamics fast. Other than that, when we deal all about the direct and indirect behavior of the control valve, so for the air to open and air to close we already discussed, and other than that for the controller, that it will be a direct acting or indirect acting controller, I already told you by the sign convention. Okay, the method in which we use the sign, or other than that simple by analyzing the closed loop diagram. Are you finding? So the last class all these points we discussed. Are you finding this point or not? So basically it is your inherently second order system. Other than that, I already told you that in the inherently second order it will be an underdamped, overdamped, critically damped or undamped system. All about the transfer function, how you can make its dynamics fast, and all about the valve characteristics, the term used in the valve, so that is sensitivity, turn down ratio, rangeability. So from all these symbols you should be very familiar, because from if they are added this particular topic P and ID symbol, so this type of question can be arises. Is it clear to you? Next one is measurement symbols. Next one is measurement symbols. So you can see in the group, I send you the two table, because with the help of these two table, you will understand all about the measurement symbols. You find it. So in the first table, let's see. In the first table, what you are finding, if it is written as AIR, so that is mean the excess air, CO, carbon monoxide, CO2, means simple in the analysis. If it is written as CO2, carbon dioxide, COL, color COMB, so that is the combustibles, COND, electrical conductivity, DN, stand for the density, GC, gas chromatograph, H2O, you know very well is water, S2S, HUM, that is the humidity, IR, so that is the infrared, LC, liquid chromatograph. So if it is written as MOIST, means moisture, MS, mass spectrometer, NIR, near infrared, O2, oxygen, you know, OP, that is the opacity, ORP, oxidation reduction, pH, that is the hydrogen ions, REF, refractometer, RI, refractive index, TC, that is the thermal conductivity, TDL, tunable diode laser, UV, ultraviolet, VIS, that is the visible light, VISC, so that is stand for the viscosity. Now the measurement symbols which basically used in flow, you can see in flow, that is the CFR, that is the constant flow regulator, cone, so that will be the cone. After that, that is the core, that is the Coriolis, DOP, Doppler, DSON, Doppler sonic, FLN, that is the flow nozzle. So all about the measurement symbol, once you will see in the table, so after that you will be easily, means you will easily understand or you will easily know. Okay, so I told you all about the flow, then level, then pressure, temperature, and after that miscellaneous. So in this case, burner, combustion, position, quantity, radiation, weight, speed. So these are some measurement symbols. So you find both of the table. So in the first table, I send you all about the analysis and flow. The second one table, so that is all about the level, pressure, temperature, and miscellaneous. Okay, so that is the burner, combustion, and position, quantity, radiation, speed, and that is the weight and force. You find it or not? Now next one, so that is all about the measurement symbol. So that is very easy. So means it will take the time if I will write out as all the measurement symbols here. Next one, that is instrument. Write down next one topic. So that will be your instrument location and identification. Identification means for the controller, you know very well all about the P and the individual I and D, combination of these. So that will be the PI, PD, or the PID controller. After that, regarding to the measurement symbol, I already told you final control element symbol. I already told you that is the line symbols. So either that is the instrument to, that is the process, or instrument to instrument. Connection. So you can easily know, easily know. So after that, the instrument लोकेशन एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन। सो इफ एनी इंस्ट्रूमेंट सपोज वी आर यूजिंग दैट इज that is the LT, so that LT is level transmitter, or either you are using that is the measuring devices to measure the level, so that will be the level measuring instrument. So simple, you can find out as this LT will be written in the circle that is also called as bubble, so either in this form this LT, if it is in the circle, but that is you can say it as this circle is divided into two parts, or either if that is the circle is divided by the dotted line, if that is the circle divided by two solid line, if that is the circle divided by two dotted line, so what does it mean? Okay, so in all about the instrument location and identification, so by some symbols we will easily recognize that the instrument is located or mounted in the plant or in the field, or either that is located or mounted in front of the control panel, means in front of the DCS system, or either that is the back of the DCS system. Okay, other than that you will find out that the particular equipment is mounted in front of the main panel, main DCS system, or you can say it as that is the secondary panel, means in front of, or you can say it as in the video display in front of the main panel, or that is the DCS system, or in front of the, or in the video display in front of the secondary panel, okay, or that is the back of the secondary panel. So by some symbols we can easily recognize, and after that by taking any example, when I will make the line symbol, the valve, and some symbols for the instrument location, so that you will easily recognize or you will easily identify that where will be the location of the instrument, in front of the panel, back of the panel, in front of the main panel or the secondary panel, or in the field, means in this way. Are you finding it or not? So write down one by one. First one, these are some points which I already told you when we complete the PDC for the first time. First one, that is simple circle, or either that circle is in the rectangular box, means this type of symbol. So what will be its symbol? So it means that is instrument, write down first, instrument is located, are you finding it or not? Instrument is located in plant, or you can say in field, this instrument will be visible at field location. This instrument will be visible at the field location, and this instrument will be normally operator accessible. So if you are finding simple, that is called as bubble, or you can say the circle. So if the bubble is in the rectangular box, okay, so what you will find out as it will be written as somehow that will be your A, B, B, or simple in this particular circle you will find out as it is written as A, B. I will tell you what does mean by the A and B. Simple, suppose if it is written as LT, you know very well L stand for that is the level, that is the first one letter. Second one letter T, so it means that is the transmitter. So that will be your level transmitter. So this level transmitter that is located in front of DCS system, back of the DCS system, or that is located in the plant. So in the process diagram, by finding such type of symbol, you can easily identify or you can easily recognize. Is this first one is clear to you or not? Tell me fast. Second one. Means we will find out as the bubble divided by the straight line, or the bubble that is filled in the rectangular box. What does it mean? It means, write down, instrument located on front of main panel in control room. Write down, it will be normally operator accessible at panel, not in the field. Are you finding this point or not? Normally operator accessible at panel, or you can write down as this instrument accessible एज पार्ट ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंट्रोल सिस्टम. सो इफ इट इज रिटन एज और इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग सच टाइप ऑफ सिंबल, लेटर आई विल टेल यू ओके, जस्ट बाय टेकिंग एनी लूप. सो इन दिस केस दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट लोकेटेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मेन पैनल इन द कंट्रोल रूम एंड दैट विल बी नॉर्मली ऑपरेटर असेसिबल एट द पैनल. दैट वॉज द नॉर्मली ऑपरेटर असेसिबल इन द फील्ड और इन द प्लांट, दैट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मेन पैनल और यू कैन सी इट एज इन फ्रंट ऑफ द डीसीएस सिस्टम और दैट इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट असेसिबल एज द पार्ट ऑफ द डीसीएस. थर्ड वन दैट इज वेरी सिंपल, मीन्स दैट विल बी द सर्किल एंड दैट इज डिवाइडेड बाई द डॉटेड लाइन और यू कैन सी इट एज सर्किल डिवाइडेड बाई द डॉटेड लाइन एंड और दिस बबल इज फिल्ड इन ए रेक्टेंगुलर बॉक्स. सच टाइप ऑफ सिंबल. सो इन दिस केस सो दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट और यू कैन आइड आउट एज इंस्ट्रूमेंट लोकेटेड इंस्ट्रूमेंट लोकेटेड इन कैबिनेट बिहाइंड पैनल मीन्स बिहाइंड द मेन पैनल. और यू कैन राइट डाउन एज इंस्ट्रूमेंट लोकेटेड इन और इंस्ट्रूमेंट लोकेटेड ऑन द बैक ऑफ पैनल इन कंट्रोल रूम. Or you can adopt as not visible on front of panel, not visible on front of panel or on video display or on video display. And it will be not normally operator accessible at panel. Fourth one, you are finding a circle with two solid line or bubble with two solid line or this bubble or the circle is covered or that is the filled by the rectangular box. So, can you tell me मीन्स आई एम टेलिंग यू अगेन व्हाट यू विल फाइंड. That in this circle it will be written as LT, okay, LIC. So just I will tell you that you will find out as either two letter or three letter. What will be the meaning of these letter? So just wait for that. For first of all, what we are understanding that if it is the simple circle and covered by a box, if that is the bubble that is divide by a solid line and covered in the box, what does it mean? Single circle divided by the dotted line covered in the box, what does it mean? Are you finding it or not? This fourth one, what does it mean? That will be your instrument. Write on first, instrument located in front of secondary, or that is also called as local panel. In this case, that will be your normally operator accessible at panel front, but that will be your local panel or the secondary panel. Fifth one, so that will be circle with two dotted lines, or you can say it as circle with two dotted line filled in a box. In this case, instrument located at back of secondary or local panel. Secondary or local panel, and it will be not normally operator accessible at panel. Are you finding? So these are the simple five symbols that should be remembered to you. After that, next one. Common identification कॉमन आइडेंटिफिकेशन लेटर्स यूज्ड इन इंस्ट्रूमेंट सिंबल्स. So suppose we have, that is the solid, I mean that is the bubble or circle, and if it is written as AB, or either if it is written as ABB, either you can find out as in this manner. So that will be the solid line. If it is written as AB, or that will be the bubble divided by the solid line ABB. Other than that, if it is dotted AB, or if it is dotted ABB, so what will be the, what do you mean by the letter A and the second letter B, or the third letter B? So simple, you should know, that is first letter, that is all about the first letter A, and that is all about the second letter B or third letter. So that will be your second or third letter B. So if you are finding on the first letter, if it is written as A, it does mean that will be the analysis. So in your book you will find out this table, and second letter, if it is written as B, so that will be your alarm. Okay, so just I will tell you that how you will read it. All about the B, so that will be your burner, combustion, C, so that will be the user's choice, you can write out as sometimes conductivity, and all about this second letter, so it will be your control. There is no need to remember it, just I will tell you that how you will read it. D, that will be your user's choice. If on the first letter, if it is written as D, it means that will be the user's choice. So sometimes that will be your density or specific gravity. E, so that will be your voltage. And second letter, so that will be your sensor element. F means that will be the first letter, F is, it does mean means that will be the flow rate. F, G, so again that will be the user choice. Sometimes that is the glass, or you can say it as viewing device. So means you will find out as such table, because I already told you that if you are finding such five symbols, so in this case you will easily find out as that the instrument is accessible in the plant, or that is accessible in the main panel, or that is the local panel, or it is accessible or not. But if there will be that two letter or either three letter that will be written inside the circle or inside this bubble, so what does it mean? So means if you are finding that is the first letter is A, so it will be the analysis. So if you are finding it as that is the G stands for, so that will be the user choice. So it will be your glass, or either that will be your viewing device. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, सो फर्स्ट लेटर मीन्स हैंड, सेकेंड लेटर सो दैट विल बी योर हाई. आई स्टैंड फॉर सो दैट विल बी द करंट, दैट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रिकल. एंड आई स्टैंड फॉर सो दैट विल बी द इंडिकेट. जी दैट इज दैट विल बी द पावर. के सो दैट विल बी द टाइम और टाइम शेड्यूल. सेकेंड लेटर सो दैट विल बी द कंट्रोल स्टेशन. एल सो एल विल बी द लेवल. एंड सेकेंड वर्ड सो दैट विल बी द लाइट और लो. Okay, so L, so that will be the level. Second letter L means so that will be the light or low. M, so that will be the user's choice. Sometimes the first letter M means moisture or humidity. Second letter M means that will be the middle or intermediate. So there is no meaning of N. O. O stands for so that will be the second. If on the second letter, if it is the so it means so that will be the orifice. Or it will be restrictions. You know very well. So that is the orifice is nothing but that is the in the pipe. So that will be simple restriction. P. So if it is written as the first letter, so it means that will be the pressure or vacuum. And if it is written on the second letter, so it means that will be the point. Q. That will be the quantity on the first letter. R, so that will be the radioactivity or ratio. First one letter, second one letter, so it's mean that will be the record. S, that will be the speed or frequency. Second letter, so that will be the switch. T, that will be the temperature. second letter, so that will be the transmit. So there is no meaning of U. V, that will be the viscosity or vibration. Second letter, so that will be the valve, damper or lower. W, so that will be the weight or force. Second letter W means, so that will be the well. Y, Y, so that will be the event. Second Y means, so that will be the relay. Compute, convert. Z, so that will be the position. And Z is set for, that will be the drive. So if I am writing it as on the first, means suppose that is if I am writing it as E R So what will be it mean if in the bubble I write it as ER? Tell me. So on the first letter it is the E. On the first letter it is the E. Tell me what will be it mean if you write it as ER. So on the first letter it is E, on the second letter if it is the R. So simple, you will understand that E stand for, that is the voltage, and on the second letter if it is written as R, what does it mean? That will be the record. So it will be the voltage record. Because sometimes we already find out as that it is written as LIC and it is written inside the circle or inside the bubble, and you will find out as a solid straight line that is dividing this bubble. What does it mean? So you will find out as that is the instrument. That is the instrument located in front of main panel. Located in front of main panel, and that is easily, or you can say the normally operator accessible in front of main panel, not in the plant. And what will be this instrument? So first letter L stand for, that is the level. Second letter I, सो दैट इज द सेकेंड, दैट इज द आई. फर्स्ट लेटर मीन्स करंट, सेकेंड लेटर आई एम टॉकिंग ऑल अबाउट द सेकेंड लेटर, सो दैट विल बी योर इंडिकेट, सो दैट विल बी योर लेवल इंडिकेट. एंड ऑन द थर्ड वन लेटर इफ इट इज रिटन एज सी, सो नाउ रीच ऑन द सी, ये आपका सी हुआ. सो अगर आपका सेकेंड लेटर पर या थर्ड लेटर पर अगर आपका मीन्स व्हाट वी आर राइटिंग दैट इज द सी, क्योंकि जैसे मैंने लिखा था कि ए बी बी मीन्स फर्स्ट लेटर इज ए, इट मीन्स दैट इज द एनालिसिस. आर यू फाइंडिंग? सो इफ इट इज रिटन एज ए ए ए, इट मीन्स, और इफ दैट इज द ए एंड ए, सो फर्स्ट लेटर ए मीन्स दैट इज द एनालिसिस. सेकेंड लेटर और सेकेंड लेटर ऑफ ए मीन्स दैट विल बी द अलार्म, सो दैट विल द एनालिसिस अलार्म. सो इन दिस वे व्हाट वी आर फाइंडिंग, फर्स्ट if I am writing it as that will be your LIC, so first A means that is all about the first letter, so that will be the A, so that will be the level. Second I am writing it as that will be your second letter, so that will be the B, so what will be the second letter, so I am writing it as that is the I, so it means that is the level, that is the second letter I means that will be the indicate. On the third letter, if that is also B, so B means that will be your second or third letter. So in this case, that is your C. What will be the C? So just reach on the C in this table. What will be the second or third letter means that will be the control. So it means LIC, you know that is your level indicate control. So can you read this particular table? And that is very easy. So most of the time we find out as that is the LT level transmitter, as we solve one question already regarding to the direct and indirect acting valve and controller. So in that case I already told you that and that was already mentioned in the question that what does mean by the LT, LC. Okay, so the same case here, that is if it is written as LIC, so first letter A, if that is your L means level, second letter that is your I means that is the second letter B, so means indicate, third letter is C, so it means that is the control, so it means that will be your level indicate control. And this instrument will be located in front of the main panel, or in front, or you can say it as in the video or in front of the video of DCS, and it will be easily accessible in front of the main panel. So that is the meaning of the symbol of this particular instrument. So you should know if that is the complete circle, that is the half circle or the half bubble, okay, or that is simply it is in the circle is in the rectangular, okay, or filled in the rectangular box or covered with the rectangular box. So just these symbols you can easily recognize what will be their meaning in the process drawing. You find it or not? So after writing some system identification, because that will be your common identification letters used in instrument symbols, so that is all about the instrument symbols I told you. Just again you can see what I am telling you. I am telling you the line symbol. The line symbols, after that final control element symbols, after that measurement symbols, then after that instrument locations and identification, then instrument symbols. common identification letters used in instrument symbols. So location of the instruments and the common identification letters used in the instrument symbols. After that, systems identification. Systems identification. Systems identification. First one is ACS. That will be your analyzer control system. ACS means analyzer control system. Second one is BMS. That will be your burner management system. Third one is CCS. Computer control system. Fourth one, that is the DCS, distributed control system. DCS stand for, that is the distributed control system. Fifth one is MMS, that is the machine monitoring system. Machine monitoring system. Next one, you can write down it as on the fourth one place. So that will be your CEMS, then fifth, then sixth. CEMS stand for, so that will be your continuous emission monitoring system. That will be your PCCS, personal computer control system. Personal computer control system. That will be your PLC, programmable logic controller. Programmable logic controller. Ninth one place, so that will be your SIS, safety instrumented system. Tenth one, so that will be the VMS, vibration monitoring system. So write down first, and after that we will draw the process diagram, then you will easily identify.
Thank you.
You write it. Okay, now it is the tank that is T101. There is a solid line that is your LE. And after that, again there is a solid line. It is your LT. So that is your bubble, and the two letters which are written as L and T. After that, it is your dotted line. And again, that is your dotted line. In the bubble, it is written as LEH. And this bubble is divided with solid line, and LEL. After that, it is your LIC. Then by dotted line, that is nothing but that is your LCV in the bubble. And after that, it is your LY. Then it will be your dotted line. So you can write down it as level control loop using P and ID symbols. Make this diagram fast. You make the diagram. Now first I discussed all about the line symbols. That is the solid line, instrument with process. Are you finding it or not? See your notes. That is all about the solid line. So that will be an instrument connection to process and equipment. So that instrument is connected to the process. You find it or not? So now first of all, just identify the line symbols used in the process diagram. So that is, and after that, that is an instrument to instrument, LE to LT, instrument to instrument. Tell me, after that these signals are your electric signal or not? These signals are electric signal. This signal is also electric signal. After that is your pneumatic signal. This is process to instrument. Are you getting it or not? So that is all about the line symbols. You know very well. Second one, we discuss all about the final control element symbols. So we are using the final control element, that is the valve. So this is your valve. Which type of valve? So that is simple generic two-way valve, or valve that is generic or simple valve, but we are using that is the actuator. So that is the symbol of the pneumatic valve. Is it or not? So that is your pneumatic valve. Tell me. After that, you can easily tell that this instrument LE is located in front of secondary panel, in front of primary or main panel, or in front of DCS, or that is located in the field. This LE LT, tell me where it will be located. Where LAH will be located, LAL will be located, LIC will be located, LY will be located, and that will be the LC be located. Can you tell or not? Can you tell me that where they will be located or where they will be mounted? So LE and LT, that will be located in the field. LIC, LAL and LAH. LAH, LA and LIC, so they will be mounted or located in front of the main panel. And LY and LCV, obviously both will be located in the field or in the plant. Now my next point is, what do you mean by the LE? First letter L means level. As I already told you, a first letter, that is your A, ए आपका क्या हो सकता है, इफ दिस फर्स्ट लेटर ए मे बी योर ए बी सी डी ई एफ जी स्टिल जेड, सो दिस फर्स्ट लेटर इज योर एल, व्हाट डज इट मीन, सेकंड लेटर दैट इज योर बी, सेकंड और थर्ड लेटर दैट इज योर बी, सो इफ दिस सेकंड लेटर इज ई, इफ द सेकंड लेटर इज ई, दैट इज द ई, व्हाट इज द सेकंड लेटर इट मीन, सो दैट विल बी योर सेंसर एलिमेंट, सो दैट विल बी योर लेवल सेंसर, एल स्टैंड फॉर दैट इज द लेवल सेंसर, सो बेसिकली टू मेजर द लेवल वी यूज द सेंसर, सो वी यूज द डिफरेंट सेंसर, सो सपोज आई एम टेकिंग इट एज दैट विल, दैट इज योर डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर सेल, इट इज नॉट कंपल्सरी दैट इट विल बी अ डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर सेल, इट मे बी एनी सेंसर विच इज बेसिकली यूज टू मेजर द लेवल, सो वॉट विल बी हैपन, इट इज मेजरिंग द लेवल बाई द हेल्प ऑफ द एल ई, दैट इज द लेवल सेंसर, बट इट इज नॉट एबल टू ट्रांसमिट द सिग्नल, सो दीज आर द बेसिकली लाइन सिंबल्स, और वी आर सेइंग इट एज दैट इज द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स, सो दिस एल टी, दैट एल टी स्टैंड फॉर, एल स्टैंड फॉर दैट इज द लेवल, फर्स्ट लेटर एल स्टैंड फॉर दैट इज द लेवल, एंड टी स्टैंड फॉर दैट इज द ट्रांसमीटर, सेकेंड लेटर और दैट इज द बी सेकेंड लेटर, सो T means transmitter, so LT stand for that is the level transmitter. What it will do? What it will do? So LT will convert the level signal, means the level to electric signal, because after that, that is your electric line. Electric signal. So, if these signals are in the form of electric current, so that will be your 4 to 20 milliampere. I already told you. If these signals are these signals, level signals converted into the electric signals. So, if that is your electric current, so that the range of the current will be from 4 to 20 milliampere. Now, LAH, that is the instrument, or basically what it is, L stand for that is the level A. Second letter, that is your A. What does it mean? So, see the A. A, what does mean by the second letter? So that is the alarm. Third letter, that is the H. H means that is the high. So when the level will be high, so it will be alarm. So that is the level alarm when the level signal becomes high inside the tank. Level alarm, L stand for, you can see that is the low. So when the signal becomes low, so that will be the level alarm low. So when the level inside the tank will be low, this alarm will start to sound. So what we are finding, after that error will be introduced and then it will be sent to the level indicating controller. So input is electric signal, output will be electric signal. Output will be your electric signal. So this, after find out the error, that error may be positive, error may be negative, or error, that is the zero. Error is nothing but that is what it is. That is the set point minus measured value. That is, remember to you or you forget. So that the error will be introduced. And this error will send to the level indicating controller. It is called as the brain of this control loop. And after that, it will read the error and corresponding it will give the output. So that depends on which means on which algorithm it is working. That is the proportional controller, that is the PI controller, that is the PID controller. Because you know, if it is the proportional controller, that output will be proportional to the input, so that is the error. So this, that signal is electric signal. But after that LY, what did it mean? So L stand for, that is the level. Second word, or second letter Y means relay, compute or convert. Means what you will do, that is the level signal convert. So Y stand for what we are finding, or either you can say it as, that is the compute or convert. What does it means? Or the level signal, you can say that is the convert or compute. What you will find out in this case, again, because this valve, that is your pneumatic valve, so input, you know all about the final control element. So final control element can, output will be what? It can manipulate the manipulated variable. What will be the input? Input will be in terms of the pressure. So we will convert the signal from the electric signal to the electrical signal to the pneumatic signal. So now electrical signal to pneumatic signal, pneumatic signal. So electric signal, suppose that is in between, or that is the range 4 to 20 milliampere, so will convert 3 to 15 PSIG pressure, pound per square inch gauge pressure. I already told you why it will be the 3, not 0. So we define term that is called as 0 and span. So on the behalf of these two parameters, that is the 0 and span, so for our purpose we can select the instrument. So we have the different instruments which specifications will be different, means 0 and span will be different. So according to our application, according to our purpose, we will select, or we can easily select the system or select the instrument. So in this case, what we are finding, that it will convert 3 to 15 PSIG. So according to that air pressure will be applied on the actuator. So corresponding to that, the valve will be open or close. So that is your level. Second letter is level control, V stand for, so that is the valve. You can see third one letter V. So V valve, third one letter or second letter. So C stand for, so that is the control. So L stand for first one letter, L stand for, so that is the level control valve. That is basically your pneumatic valve. So that will be your level control valve. So the level indicating controller will decide that what will be the output, and after that it will give this signal to, that is the LCV, level control valve, and after that, according to the input given by the controller, it will take the action. So means क्या एक्शन लेना है, सो दैट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द कंट्रोलर. उसको एग्जीक्यूट कौन करेगा, सो दैट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय द वॉल्व. सो दैट विल बी योर लेवल कंट्रोल वॉल्व. सो दैट इज वेरी सिंपल सिस्टम, दैट इज द लेवल कंट्रोल लूप, क्लोज लूप. बिकॉज इन द क्लोज लूप वी आर कंट्रोलिंग द लेवल ऑफ द फ्लूइड इनसाइड द टैंक. that and with the help of the P and ID symbols. Now I hope that P and ID symbols or this particular topic is clear to you. So, okay, so that is for the today class. In the next class, I will complete your next topic. Okay.